Isolation and inactivity can become a veteran's new enemy once they've left the battlefront. But three Iraq War veterans discovered how camaraderie and friendly competition at the VA Summer Sports Clinic are important allies in their rehabilitation back to civilian life.
I lost 15 pounds in 2 weeks. I spent days on end crying, days on end not eating.
I was almost homeless for a little bit.
I'm not ashamed to admit that I was really in a really dark hole and I did not want to seek therapy. I did not want to seek help.
Carlos Figueroa, Crystal Stokes, and Shaka Green, three combat veterans who returned home only to face new battles as civilians.
It was really difficult for me to calm down. It was hard for my wife. She's a strong woman. I mean, she went through a lot with me. And the sad part is my children are in the middle of that. And so we divorced.
After 13 years in the Marines, including two tours in Iraq, Shaka returned home with PTSD to a civilian life that now seemed unfulfilling.
I mean, literally riding my motorcycle as fast as possible with as many people as possible, stunts, racetracks, halo, anything that was activating and stimulating, I was running after at 100 miles an hour because you miss that, even though you wanted to come home, you miss that feeling, that instantaneous, I am literally activated feeling.
I didn't really know what I wanted to do with myself. The only thing I'd done my entire life was the Marine Corps, and I was good at it. So the fact that I didn't have that, I was kind of lost. I didn't know what to do.
Even being from a Marine Corps family didn't prepare 11-year veteran Crystal Stokes for her transition to civilian life. Crystal served three combat tours in Iraq, struggled with PTSD, a knee injury, and feelings of isolation.
I went through a period where I had to get help from a family member in order to pay rent. I didn't have anywhere to go, didn't have any idea what was going on. I was injured, then I couldn't work, couldn't do anything.
An IED hit me. I injured two ribs, fractured one. 2 months exactly to the day when I went out is when I was injured by another IED.
After losing a leg in that second blast, Marine Corps and Army veteran Carlos Figueroa sank into a deep depression when he came home. He figured the active lifestyle he dearly loved was over.
I actually ended up turning towards alcohol and realized that's not the route I wanted to go, and that's when I started seeking help at the VA.
One by one, these fearless warriors found that by arming themselves with intense physical activity, they could stand up to the challenges of civilian life. Shaka Green uses the same Marine Corps regimen that whipped him into shape for Iraq to cope with PTSD.
When you're accustomed to putting your body through the rigmarole, you have to keep doing that. You have to figure out how you can match your civilian life with the same level of stimulation so you're not so easily stimulated.
Oh, that one, she's tighter than the other.
Crystal's athletic prowess and Marine Corps training also paid off in a surprising way. She was recruited to play for the San Diego Surge professional women's football team.
I'm on defense. I'm a defensive end. It's an awesome feeling. I love it. It's great.
And she found a camaraderie similar to the Marines with her new teammates.
They've gotten through me through a lot. They've seen me at some of my lowest. They've seen me irritated. They've seen me mad. They've seen me happy. They've seen me sad. That if I ever really truly needed anything, they'd be there in a heartbeat with the help.
This summer, Crystal, Shaka, and Carlos were among 100 other veterans who joined together at the National Veterans Summer Sports Clinic in San Diego.
Extra points, Joe.
Splitting into teams, they took aim at kayaking, rowing, judo, sailing, cycling, and Crystal's favorite, archery.
You hit it!
She even made a point of encouraging reluctant teammates.
High five it, good job!
They gained the opportunity to challenge themselves outside of their local community, and also see the VA in a whole different light.
The Marine Corps, we call it a esprit de corps. You touch each other and you amplify that energy. You all feel it together as a group because that's what you did in the military. You did it as a group, as a team.
Get to meet some new people and kind of connect, be able to actually be able to talk to people and use whatever terminology I want and have them not look at me like I've got 3 to 5 eyeballs or something, you know?
There you go.
And after taking part in 3 summer clinics, Carlos found new inspiration here by serving as a mentor.
And what happens here, what's afforded us to do these events, open doors for us, open doors for tons of vets that may have sat in their hotel room, may have sat in their bedroom and didn't want to come out. And they do this event and they realize, okay, kayaking is my sport. Surfing is going to be my passion, you know? So it's made wonders. It's opened a lifetime for me of friendships.
Carlos also participates at the National Veterans Winter Sports Clinic in Colorado, where he excels in snowboarding. VA has a variety of competitions, including the Golden Age Games, Wheelchair Games, and the Summer and Winter Sports Clinic. Is it time for you to compete? Go to va.gov for more information on the games.